Mr. Deputy Chairman, while speaking on this measure, I cannot forget that this is only a part of what is in store for the taxpayer, because we know there are the other measures passed by the Lok Sabha. There are yet others pending before them, and there may be many more in the conception of the finance ministry. However, I cannot help sympathizing with the finance minister in his having to present this finance bill. In the first place, he had to do it because he was hard pressed to find money for the 12-5-year plan. The way in which these proposals were received throughout the country is well known. I believe, sir, it is true that no budget ever created so much sensation, caused so much NXT, affected so much the rich and the poor alike, and brought down with such a crash the value of the shares and stocks in the stock exchanges. The finance minister had to do all this because he was to find the money for the 12-5-year plan. But it was that the 5-year plan would succeed with this money, I would not have minded it. But as layman, I have certain doubts in my mind. It is true, sir, it is obvious that more taxes bring more revenue to government, while deficit financing leads to a rise in prices and inflationary trends. Have we taken into consideration what will be the effect of all these measures on the general economy of the country? What will be the effect of all these measures on the price index, on food prices and manufactured goods? And what will be the effect of all these measures on the cost of production? I think these things must be taken into consideration. Sir, no amount of arguments or theories can refute and disprove facts. The fact remains that as soon as these proposals were out, the price index began to rise, and this fact is in evidence today. This rise in the price index is a definite proof that these taxation measures are creating inflation. Now we know, sir, that government themselves had to increase the price of steel, coal and cement. What will be the effect of this? The increase in the price of steel and iron will naturally increase the cost, because all the agricultural implements will cost the farmer more. As far as coal is concerned, every concern that generates power with the help of coal will be affected, and its production will become more costly. This will be the effect of all these things, with the result that there will be a demand for an increase of wages in all such industrial concerns. Government employees have already started an agitation and are becoming restive, and government has rightly appointed the pay commission. I do not wish to anticipate the recommendations of the pay commission, but one thing is certain, that the pay commission is going to recommend some increase. It may be small, it may be substantial, or it may not be substantial, but they are bound to recommend some increase in the wages considering the price index at present. Now, when their recommendations will be out, the employees of the state government will follow suit. Then the employees of all the private concerns will follow suit, with the result that these measures will make the 12th plan most costly. They will contribute to the rise in prices, and therefore I should like the finance minister to consider whether these measures are going to lead to deflation or inflation. That is the real point that should be borne in mind. Then, as was just said by my friend, our greatest need today is to find more foreign exchange, and we can get foreign exchange only by exporting goods. Well, if this is the condition in the country, it is really questionable. It is very doubtful if our products will be able to compete with the foreign products in other countries. Sir, we are hoping to get rupees 1100 crores out of this taxation. Of that, rupees 500 crores will go to our defense, and it must go towards that, because we cannot take any risk with the security of the country. I am told that one of the most prominent members of this government said that if there is an increase of rupees 200 in the wages of our servants, it will cost another rupees 500 crores. So rupees 500 crores will go to defense, another rupees 500 crores will go towards the increase in the salaries of government servants, and what will remain is only rupees 100 crores. Will it be sufficient for the 12-5-year plan? So I doubt whether we will be able to make a success of our 5-year plan by these measures. The remedy is, as the finance minister himself if has said, in rephasing the plan. Rephasing is inevitable in the circumstances, and it should be faced boldly.